Tonight, the Tigers invade Yankee Stadium for a three-game series in hopes of cooling off the New Yorkers. The Yankees stand in second place in the East, just a game and a half in front of Detroit. The Tigers send Jack Morris minus his stiff neck to the mound as Detroit looks to climb two games over 500. It's the Tigers and Yankees live from Yankee Stadium. Tigers 87. Today's game is brought to you by Meisterbrau Beer. Nothing's richer, nothing smoother. Who needs anything else? By McDonald's. It's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's. By Highland Superstores. They have the biggest selection of TVs, stereos, and appliances in every store. Nobody, but nobody, sells for less. And by Ameritech Pages Plus. Next to the phone, there's nothing better.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Yankee Stadium in New York. I'm George Kell, along with Al Kaline, and we're getting ready to go with the first of a three-game series, all-night games here in Yankee Stadium. It's going to be a classic pitching matchup here tonight. Jack Morris will pitch for the Tigers. Jack's won one, lost one this year. His only loss coming to the Yankees in 10 innings on opening day. And his mound opponent will be Rick Rhoden, who came to the Yankees from the National League. Rick lost his first outing, and then he was a winner against Cleveland. So he's 1-1. Al Kaline is here, and he has the starting lineup.
Okay, here's the way the Tigers will bat. Leading off will be the second baseman, Lou Whitaker. Batting second, the right fielder, Pat Sheridan. Batting third, Matt Noakes is the DH. Batting fourth, playing first base, is Darrell Evans. Batting fifth, the left fielder, John Grubb. Batting sixth, Darnell Coles in right and third base. Batting seventh, Chet Lemon, the center fielder. Batting eighth, and the catcher, Dwight Lowry. And batting ninth will be the shortstop, Tom Brookins. Defensively for the Yankees in the outfield, Pasqua Hendrick, Claudel Washington, a late entry, and Winfield in right field. Pagliarulo, Tolleson, Randolph, Mattingly at first base. Skinner will be the catcher, and Rick Rhoden will be the pitcher for the Yankees. As George Kell mentioned, has a record of 1-1. He lost his first game against Kansas City, lasted only 3 1/3 innings, allowed 9 hits and 5 runs. He won here at Yankee Stadium on the 15th against Cleveland, a score of 4-3. He went 7 innings, allowed 6 hits, 3 runs. He walked one and struck out two. Rick, originally signed by the Brooklyn Dodgers, he pitched for the Dodgers in 1974, was traded to Pittsburgh in 1979. He has been a workhorse for a very poor Pittsburgh Pirate ball club. Last season, he won 15 and lost 12. He features 4 different pitches, consistent with all of them. He's around the plate all the time. Good fastball, slider, curveball, and a straight changeup. This should be a real good pitching battle against two workhorses. Rick Rhoden, the big guy, you can see, tall, lanky. He has a deformed right knee. He had osteomyelitis when he was a kid, and he had to take some of his right knee away, and that hurt him somewhat, but he has been an outstanding pitcher.
Yeah, he's been a good one, and the Yankees have been trying to get him for the last couple of years, and they swung a deal for him to bolster their pitching staff, and they expect him to be the ace of the staff over here. In his first outing, he was bombed in Kansas City and gave up 9 hits over there. Yankees lost that game 13-1, but he came back to beat the Cleveland ball club 4-3 in his second start. So he's making his third start of the year tonight. Morris against Rhoden. And Whitaker will lead it off for the Tigers. The first pitch of the ball game, and it's a strike. That is Tim Welke behind the plate tonight. Joe Brinkman is at first base. Terry Cooney, the umpire, at second. And Mike Riley, the umpire, at third base. And the one strike pitch to Whitaker. That's a ball. Whitaker, Sheridan, and Noakes will be the Tiger batters in the first inning. The 1-1 pitch. Hit high in the air into center field. It's Claudel Washington out there. Claudel got into the game at the last moment. Ricky Henderson was announced, and he was scratched with a slight muscle pull, was the announcement from the press box. And the batter is Pat Sheridan.
Rick Rhoden was to be the starting pitcher against Jack Morris at Tiger Stadium, but he had a slight side pull, and he missed that turn.
And the Tigers and Yankees instead started Dennis Rasmussen, who was absolutely brilliant on that day. Yankees won it in 10 innings, 2-1. One strike to Sheridan. Lou Piniella in the dugout. Strike two. He got the outside corner. Two strikes to Pat. They had opening day in Montreal today. The Expos finally got home for opening day in their new dome stadium. They led most of the game, but the Phillies pulled it out, beat them 4-3. Strike two to Sheridan. And he pops it up. It's maybe a little trouble. It's going to drop in. Pat hit it right on the fist and dropped it into shallow center field.
You see Pat just trying to fight off two strikes, and he just loops it in the short center field. This is what you're going to see a lot of from Rick Rhoden. He is around the plate with all of his pitches. He's not overpowering, but he has excellent control.
So the Tigers have a runner at first, one out, and the batter will be Matt Noakes, who is the designated hitter tonight. Matt Noakes batting at 367. Slow curveball. He floated that one up there like a wounded bird. Matthew has two home runs, six runs batted in. And it hasn't been a cheap 367. Matt has hit some balls very hard. In Kansas City, in one ball game, he hit three shots that were caught. There goes the base runner. And he's going to be out. Collison made a whale of a play. Normally, when you bounce it down there, Al, they can't get it down for a tag.
Especially on regular turf, George, but Skinner is probably the best throwing catcher they've had here since Thurman Munson. He is an excellent defensive catcher. You can see the short hop, but Collison makes an excellent tag right on the money.
It's 1-2 to Matt Noakes. They're keeping score. Sheridan is out. 2-6, catcher to the shortstop. And the 1-2 pitch to Noakes. Check swing ground ball. Here's the throw, and he gets in. Good play by Tolleson. He had to go in the hole and get it on the short hop and make a quick throw to first. We go to the bottom of the first. There is no score.
Okay, here's the way the Yankees will bat, leading off Clardell Washington in center field. Batting second, Willie Randolph, the second baseman. Batting third, Don Mattingly, first base. Batting fourth, playing right field, Dave Winfield. Batting fifth, Dan Pasqua, left fielder. Batting sixth and DH, Gary Ward. Batting seventh, the third baseman, Mike Pagliarola. Batting eighth, Joel Skinner is the catcher. Batting ninth, the shortstop, Wayne Tolleson. Defensively for the Tigers, Grubb, Lemon, and Sheridan in the outfield. Coles, Brookins, Whitaker, Evans, Dwight Lowry is behind the plate, and Jack Morris is on the mound for the Detroit Tigers. Jack, a record of 1-1. He has pitched just two excellent games already this season. Pitched against the Yankees opening day, lost that game 2-1. He pitched nine innings, nine hits, two runs. He walked two and struck out four. And he was a winner against Chicago April the 11th. 7-1 over the White Sox. Struck out 10 in that ball game. Of course, Jack has been an excellent pitcher, as we well know. Tiger fans, last season, tremendous year, 21-8. Jack missed a turn, supposed to pitch in Detroit against the White Sox, but he had a stiff neck and was able to pitch the last couple of games. But Sparky Anderson thought that he should get Jack Morris completely well. So now he is pitching here in the opening night of the series against the Yankees.
How about that Kansas City ball club? They were shut out twice here yesterday. They lost a doubleheader at Yankee Stadium, both shutouts. Today they went to Fenway Park in Boston, and behind Brett Saberhagen, they beat the Red Sox 10-2. And they're going to be without George Brett for a period of time, 3 to 6 weeks, the report said. He has the same type injury as this Kirk Gibson. Claudell Washington will lead it off. Claudell getting into the lineup in place of Ricky Henderson. He'll be followed by Willie Randolph and then Don Mattingly. And the 1-0 pitch from Morris. It's a ball, ball two. Ball two, no strikes. Toronto plays at Cleveland. Milwaukee's in Chicago, the amazing Milwaukee Brewers. Going for number 13. There's a foul out of play. And they've got their no-hit pitcher, Nieves, going tonight.
And that would be, if they win this game tonight, will be a record, wouldn't it?
Would tie the Braves and would set an American League record. The Braves had 13 in a row, I believe, in 1981. Tie a major league record. Ball three, strike one. Chuck Wozlik says if they win tonight, they will tie the major league record set by the Atlanta Braves. The 3-1 pitch. It's high, ball four. Claudell Washington gets a walk to start the ball game.
Well, this happens a lot with Jack Morris. It takes him a little bit of time to get adjusted to the mound. He usually is able to adjust very quickly.
Runner at first, nobody out, and the batter is Willie Randolph. Willie batting at 310. No home runs, and he has 7 runs batted in. The American League record for most wins at the beginning of a year was 11 until yesterday. 11 by the Oakland Ball Club, and Milwaukee topped that by winning yesterday in a very dramatic manner, you might say. They were behind 4-1 in the ninth inning. There goes the runner. Throw to second and safe. Throw was in the dirt, and Whitaker couldn't come up with it. A stolen base for Washington.
Claudell, even though he's getting up in age, still has excellent speed. Ball is a short hop again. This time getting by Lou Whitaker. A good throw, I believe, would have had him.
Yeah, a good throw, and he's out, Al. The ball was there before the runner. One strike to Willie Randolph. And he fouls it away. You can see Willie Randolph trying to hit the ball to right field.
He is a professional baseball player. He knows how to play the game, and he does all the little things that all the third, fourth, and fifth place hitters appreciate, and certainly all the managers that he plays for appreciate. He does the little things.
It's strike two to Willie. Runner at second, nobody out. And a pitch inside makes it 1-2. Seattle at Minnesota, Oakland at California, other games in the American League. And this afternoon, Kansas City 10, Boston 2. Right to the mound. Morris bluffs the runner back. So he gets a big out. He gets Willie Randolph, holds the runner at second. the batter will be Don Mattingly.
And this is the 26th birthday of Don Mattingly. Can you imagine only 26 years old, George? I told you earlier, before he's finished playing, he'll probably be making $3 million a year if he keeps going at the pace he is.
You see nothing but good things happening for this fellow. Pitch is high to Mattingly. I'd be very much surprised if he gets anything good to hit right now, with first base open and a right-handed batter coming up. It's a breaking ball low. Ball two, no strikes. He's batting only .250. He's had one home run this year and 13 runs batted in.
But he has six hits in his last three games, so he's getting back on schedule now. I don't think Lou Piniella is worried too much about Don Mattingly.
It's ball two and no strikes as Morris gets his sign from Dwight Lowry. And there's a long breath way back in right field and gone.
Well, what a birthday present. Don Mattingly, who got off to a bad start this season at Tiger Stadium particularly, but he has been getting hot the last three games. Jack Morris behind in the count. You see Dwight Lowry wanted the ball outside. Jack Morris got it inside. And he knew what to do with it.
Yeah, not much doubt about it. He hit it well back into the seats. 2-0, the Yankees lead it. And the batter is Dave Winfield. One ball, no strikes to Big Dave. Yankees are off to their best start in a long time. They're 9-3 on the year. And they've been getting better pitching than anybody thought they would, as evidenced by the double shutout yesterday. Ball hit to third and off the glove of Darnell. Winfield slammed it hard and off the glove of Darnell Coles. We'll take another look at it.
Ball was hit rather hard, but Darnell, instead of trying to get in there and play the short hop, decided to play it on the big hop. Looked like a tough play to handle, though.
That'll be an error against Darnell. Puts a runner at first, one out, and the batter is Dan Pasqua. Dan Pasqua. This fellow had a brilliant spring training. He just wore everybody out and now having trouble getting started. Batting at 0-91.
Maybe one of the strongest guys in the American League right now. He can hit the ball a long ways.
There's a strike. He got a changeup over. 1-1 to Pasqua.
The hitting book on Pasqua is throw him a lot of off-speed pitches. Try to stay away from throwing him a fastball inside.
And the pitch. Ball hit up the middle. Winfield makes the turn. He'll go into third. Dan Pasqua slammed it hard through the middle into center field. So the Yankees have him at first and third. One out. Well, he hit a good pitch.
Hit a good pitch. They're playing him well around the pole. You see Lou Whitaker made a good effort. Not able to get there. Sparky Anderson on his way out to talk to Jack Morris.
Not exactly what the Tigers had in mind, the way to start this ball game. Jack walked Claudel Washington to start the game. He stole second base on the first pitch. Then they got Willie Randolph to bounce to the mound. Mattingly hit a two-run homer. Winfield safe on an error, and then Pasqua getting a base hit. The batter is Gary Ward. Big scoreboard here estimates Mattingly's home run travel 402 feet. Ball should be a double play ball out at second, relay and out at first. Gary Ward hit the first pitch to Brookins and they turn the double play. Two runs in the inning. On a couple of hits, an error and a walk, they strand one, and at the end of one, the Yankees lead it 2-0. Here's Darrell Evans will lead it off. John Grubb and Darnell Coles will follow. 2-0, the Yankees lead it. A walk to Washington and a two-run homer by Mattingly. In the old double play ball, the pitcher's friend helped Jack Morris get out of the inning without further trouble. Rick Rhoden is ready, and the pitch to Darrell Evans is outside. Philadelphia beat Montreal 4-3, the home opener for Montreal today in their new dome stadium. There's a ball hit deep into center field. Way back goes Washington near the fence, and he's going to catch it. Darrell Evans hit it deep into center field, and Claudel Washington ran it down. We're going to pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're watching Tigers 87.
This is Kirk Gleason. Coming up in our late news, we'll have reports on Governor Blanchard's call for a crackdown on guns in schools and on an historic return to Northern Michigan. These stories and more after the game.
John Grubb looking for his first base hit. And a strike, slow curveball. John, who had a tremendous year in 86, and Al, he just can't get on track.
No, you know, it was unfortunate for John in spring training. The last week, 10 days of spring training, the weather was bad, and then when they were able to play, they faced nothing but left-handed pitching, and he never had a chance to play.
One ball, one strike to Grubb. And a ball hit on the ground toward Willie Randolph. He'll toss him out, and there's two outs. Johnny Grubb is out, second to first, and the batter will be Darnell Coles. Darnell has been struggling a bit. He's batting an even 200. He bats with two outs, nobody on here in the second inning. Rhoden delivers the curve low. And the big right-hander gets ready. That'll make it 1-1. I tell you, he looks tough with that very unorthodox delivery. Sort of slingshots the ball at you.
Has excellent control, he always has. He never beats himself.
And a pop up could be in play. There's not much room down there, and it's going to be out of play. Very little room between the foul line and the stands. Not a bad crowd here on a Monday night. We had some rain about 6:30 tonight. It's been a cloudy, overcast day in Manhattan. Not a bad day at all. Temperature supposed to get up around 62. Good stop by Skinner. Ball two and strike two. The Mets are in Pittsburgh tonight. They were swept over the weekend by the Cardinals. Lost three in St. Louis. This is foul. And what a very unfortunate accident to John Tudor of the Cardinals. Sitting on the bench, minding his own business, and a pop fly foul over the dugout, and the young catcher for the Mets came charging over, barreled into the dugout, slammed into John Tudor, and broke his leg. He struck him out. He pulled the string on him, and Darnell Coles, a strikeout victim. Well, the Tigers go out 1-2-3. We go to the bottom of the second. 2-0 Yankees. Mike Paliarulo will lead it off for the Yankees, followed by Joel Skinner and then Wayne Tolleson. The Yankees announced today, just before the start of the game, that they had released right-handed pitcher Mike Armstrong. Mike had been signed to a Columbus contract. He was with the Yankees last year. And they announced today he had been released by the Columbus club. The pitch to Paliarulo. He foul tips it. This fella had a big spring training, and he's getting off to a slow start. Paliarulo batting at 214. No home runs, and he has four runs batted in. Here's a drive to right that's going to be caught. Paliarulo hit it on the line right straight to Sheridan in right field. The batter will be the catcher, Joel Skinner. Well, May 1st is just around the corner. It's going to be a very exciting time. There's half dozen free agents or so that will be eligible to sign again. Bob Boone out in California. Ron Guidry with this ball club. They've got to be getting a little bit anxious. The 1-0 pitch to Skinner. Ooh, look out. Ball two, no strikes. Bob Horner is already signed, I guess, with the Japanese ball.
Japanese
club.
Team.
He's going to go to Japan. Ball hit to third. Here's the long throw by Coles, and he's out. Joel Skinner bounces out, third to first. And the batter will be Wayne Tolleson.
Horner was going to Japan. There was one promoter who wanted him to also be a professional wrestler over there. I guess he's put on quite a bit of weight. I think he's up about 230, 240 now.
With the regimentation they have, or they tell me they have, with the Japanese ball clubs, they may take about 50 pounds off Bob Horner. They work out every morning about 3 hours and play in the afternoon. One ball, no strikes to Tolleson. That'll make it 2-0 to Wayne. Wayne Tolleson, the Yankee shortstop. Dick Trzuski moving the outfielders around toward left. They do not expect him to pull the ball off Morris. Ball two, no strikes. Ball three outside. 3-0, says Tim Welke.
Well, Jack, who has missed 3 days, normally he pitches in his regular turn. He's looks like he's very strong now, and he doesn't have good location with his pitches.
And a strike. He threw it right down the middle to Tolleson. Pittsburgh leads the Mets 4-2. They're in the third inning. Philadelphia beat Montreal 4-3 in an afternoon game. The 3-1 pitch. Ball hit on the ground to shortstop. Tommy Brookins tosses him out. So an easy 1-2-3 inning for Jack Morris. And at the end of two, the Yankees lead it 2-0. Chester Lemon will lead it off for the Tigers in the third inning. Lemon, Lowry, and Brookins against the big right-hander Rick Rhoden. Cleveland got two, and they lead Toronto 2-0 in Cleveland tonight. Here's the pitch to Lemon. Fly ball into left. And Pasqua moves into left center field, and he'll put it away. So one pitch and one out. The Cleveland club won a doubleheader yesterday. They had won only one ball game all year until yesterday. They beat Baltimore, a doubleheader. Greg Swindle retired the Baltimore club 1-2-3 in the first inning, And that's only the second time all year that the Cleveland club had retired the opposing team 1-2-3 in the first inning.
Many pick Cleveland to be a solid contender this year, and certainly they still may be if they get any kind of pitching at all.
Yeah, they've just given up a ton of runs here in the early part of the season. In the first inning tonight, they made two runs, and Joe Carter made one of them when he stole home plate. This is out of play, foul. Strike two to Dwight Lowry. Rick Rhoden gets ready, and the strike two pitch to Lowry. Here's a drive into right center. This is in for a base hit. White's going to hold with a single as Claudel gets it back in. Second Tiger hit. Oh, with two strikes on him, the young man gets a good curveball.
Yeah, he's had success throwing that slow curveball to the Tiger hitter so far in tonight's game. Dwight Lowry, who is not a pole hitter, stayed on the pitch and hit it to center field.
And the batter is Brookins with a runner at first and one out. Tigers trail by two here in the third. And a pitch outside. Tim Welke behind the plate. Joe Brinkman at first base. Terry Cooney at second. And our good buddy Mike Riley on at third base. Mike Riley from Battle Creek. Foul ball. Tommy was jumping on that high fastball all day yesterday, and he waved at this one.
Tommy, of course, playing shortstop in place of Alan Trammell. Alan Trammell could be available for duty tonight if needed.
There's the breaking ball low. Ball two and strike one. Tommy has just been magnificent filling in for Alan Trammell. He's batting 348. He has batted in five. And just played super shortstop. That's the breaking ball. And the count goes even at 2-2.
Yeah, if the Tigers can hang tough and stay around the 500 mark until they get Trammell, Gibson, and Hernandez back, I think they would have played very good baseball.
Tommy pops it up outside of first base. Mattingly near the stands, and he can't get it. The wind is blowing from left field toward first base and toward home plate, and it blows it away from him.
Talking to Sparky Anderson before the game, and the due date, the day that he says Gibson will play, will be May the 5th. That is the game out, and I think we're in Oakland when Gibson will get back into the lineup. Of course, Sparky has a tendency to do a lot of talking.
The 2-2 pitch, ball three, 3-2 to Brookins. Well, it's a very painful injury.
Yes.
When you pull a muscle in the rib cage, and there's nothing you can do except wait until it heals.
Sparky had predicted Gibson would not be back until the middle of May.
And he might not. There he goes, and a foul out of play. George Brett just suffered the same injury here in the first inning yesterday, and they say he might be out as long as 6 weeks. Dwight Lowry was on the way when Brookins fouled it off, so we'll do it again. There he goes. And he pops this one back on the screen. Here comes Skinner. And it's going to be out of play. Ball three, strike two to Tom Brookins. Tigers have a runner at first, one out, and they trail by two here in the third inning. As Sparky looks on. Ball hit deep into left center field. Way back goes Washington. He caught it in deep left center field. Oh, would you believe it?
And the only way he catches up to this ball is because the wind is blowing in from left field. Ball would have, no question, would have been up against the fence, possibly out of the ballpark, but there is a breeze blowing in from left field. An excellent running catch by Claudel Washington, who was a late replacement for Ricky Henderson because Henderson has a slight leg pull.
And nowhere but Yankee Stadium would that ball be caught. That would have been in the upper deck in Detroit. Home run Kansas City, Boston, you name it. But it's Death Valley here in Yankee Stadium, 411 feet in the alley and left center. And the batter is Whitaker. It's a strike. Lou flied to center field to start the ball game. And a pitch outside. Lou had 20 home runs and batted in 73 runs in 1986. One ball, one strike. Ball two, 2-1 to Whitaker. Lemon opened the inning with a fly ball to left. Lowry singled into center field. Brookins was out on a tremendous drive into deep left center. Now it's ball two, strike one to Whitaker. Ball three. 3-1 to Lou. And if you know Lou Whitaker, he'll be looking for something here that he can pull down the line and hit hard. Tigers down by two. And he fouls it away. Lou reached out over the plate for that one. Ball three, strike two. Lowry will move on the pitch. Rhoden hasn't walked anybody, and he doesn't walk many. Here's the payoff. He struck him out. Whitaker got a piece of it. Foul tipped it right into the glove of Joel Skinner. We go to the bottom of the third. It's still the Yankees 2 and the Tigers nothing. Well, they're playing Happy Birthday to Don Mattingly right now. And giving a rerun of the home run he hit in the first inning. That's been the difference in the ball game. A two-run homer by Mattingly, and the Yankees lead it 2-0. Claudel Washington will lead it off, and he'll get a big ovation. Fellow made a whale of a play on Tom Brookins. Jack Morris delivers. Claudel got into the game at the last moment in place of Ricky Henderson. You'd think that would be a big break for the Tigers because Henderson is just all kinds of trouble for the Tigers. There's a fly ball to center. But it hasn't panned out that way. Washington walked, scored a run in the first inning, and then made a great running catch on Brookins to save the run. He's out to lead off the third, and the batter will be Willie Randolph, who bounced to the mound his first time. And the pitch to Willie. Ball hits slowly towards shortstop. Brookins on to Evans. It's the second time he has got in on the fist of Randolph and just sawed the bat off in his hands.
Well, you can see the difference in Jack Morris the last two innings rather than the first inning. He has better control of his pitches now. He more or less knows where he's going to throw the pitch. In the first inning, he was kind of wild, and of course, he was behind in the count to Don Mattingly. He wanted to throw the pitch outside, got it right into his wheelhouse on the inside part of the plate.
Here's Mattingly, and he takes it inside. Oh, no. In Chicago, Greg Brock, the first baseman for the Milwaukee Ball Club, has just hit a two-run homer, and they lead Chicago 2-0. I don't know what this would be about. Do you, Al?
Well, Jack was very upset on the call, and he said something to the plate umpire, and then he took a few steps out to Jack Morris, and Sparky Anderson is out here to try to settle Jack down.
And he might be waiting for Welke to get to the mound too.
Yeah, this is the old ploy by management to have the umpire come out, and he'll get a chance to say a few words to the umpire.
And he is not inviting him to eat with him after the game, I can tell you that right now. One ball, no strikes to Mattingly. Here's the changeup, high ball two. I think the best way to pitch Mattingly is don't. Just don't throw him a strike. Ball three. It was 2-0 in the first inning. Morris threw him a fastball. He hit a home run. 2-0 here, and he changed up on him. Ball three, no strikes. And another changeup. He just gave him the semi-intentional pass. Second walk for the Yankees. And the batter will be the big guy, Dave Winfield. Dave was safe on an error in the first inning.
Right fielder, Dave Winfield.
Winfield batting at 386, one home run, six runs batted in. This one gets away, and down to second goes Mattingly. More than likely it'll be a wild pitch. The ball hit in the dirt, bounced off the mitt of Lowry. We'll look at it right here. You see,
that's a wild pitch. A wild pitch
charged against Jack Morris. So Mattingly at second, two outs, one ball, no strikes to Winfield. Ball is foul toward the Tiger dugout. It's Mike Ferraro, the third base coach for the Yankees. Big Dave Winfield played out his contract with San Diego and was a big signee here with the Yankees, and he has had some great years. 1-2.
Yeah, he was criticized quite a bit last year, George. You know, all he did was hit 26 home runs and drove in 104 runs.
Criticized only by the owner.
By the owner. He says he's paid much better than to only drive in 104 runs. He hit 262.
One ball, two strikes, and he checked his swing. That'll make it 2-2, and Morris thought he had him. Jack started to the batter's box to say something to Welkin. He stopped. Take a look at it and see if you thought he swung at it. Jack thought it was a strike. Ball two and strike two. That'll make it 3-2. Dan Paskov would bat next if Winfield gets on. Winfield is what is known in the business as a dead fastball hitter. He just sits on the fastball, and he's a good fastball hitter. A 3-2 pitch. He walked it. Winfield gets a walk. That's the second walk this inning. And the batter will be Pasqua, who singled his first time up. Two on and two outs in the third inning, and the Yankees lead by two. This fellow has batted in one run this year, and that was yesterday in a game the Yankees won 1-0. A strike to Pasqua. Cleveland 2, Toronto 1 in the second inning. Milwaukee got 2 in the first inning. White Sox are batting. This is fouled away. You see the base runners. Winfield's at first, Mattingly at second with two outs. And the two strike pitch. He pops it foul, out of play. Jack got the first two batters rather easily. Washington flied to center. Willie Randolph bounced to the shortstop. But he walked Mattingly on four pitches. Then he went to 3-2 and walked Winfield. Now he's in front of Pasqua with a strike two count. And he pops it up. John Grubb in left field moving in under it. At the end of three, the Yankees 2 and the Tigers nothing. Here come the Tigers in the fourth inning. Pat Sheridan will lead it off, followed by Matt Noakes and then Darrell Evans. 2-0, the Yankees lead it. On a strike on the outside corner. Rick Rhoden is ready, and a foul ball that'll be out of play. Strike two to Sheridan. Well, after each televised Tiger game, Al and I will be announcing the Miller Lite Tiger Player of the Game. The winner will have $100 donated in his name to the Children's Hospital of Michigan by the Miller Brewing Company. The pitch to Sheridan outside, 1-2. Cleveland got another run. They lead Toronto 3-1. They're in the third inning. Pat fouls it away. Sheridan had a single his first time up. He dropped a pop fly between the shortstop, the second baseman, and the center fielder. The 1-2 pitch. Ooh, look out. That'll even the count at 2-2. Tigers have only two hits and only two base runners. He struck him out. Strikeout number three for Rhoden. Looks like a fastball, Al.
Yeah, he had pitched him outside and he came in, and this time he tries to go outside. You can see right in the catcher's mitt on the outside corner. Well, I've been impressed with Rick Rhoden so far. He looks like he has excellent control.
I'll bring up Matt Noakes, who bounced out to the shortstop. Matt's 0-1. And a pitch outside. Two runs on two hits for the Yankees. No runs on two hits for the Tigers. The difference, a two-run homer by Don Mattingly. And this one fouled away. One ball, one strike to Noakes. Matthew is the designated hitter for Sparky. Rick Rhoden is ready. Oh, I get ball two and strike one. He got that one right in on the fist and just sort of tied him up, but it was inside. Thirty-3 years old, Rick Rhoden. Came to the major leagues in 1975 with the Dodgers. And a fly ball into shallow right center field. Winfield and whoops. Claudel Washington wisely got out of the way. Boy, this big fella run you down. You might be there for a while.
Claudel is not that small, but when you stand up next to Dave Winfield, he looks like he's small, but Claudel is about 6'2".
That's Winfield 6'7".
6'7".
He was offered a professional basketball contract.
All three sports.
Football, too?
Football.
I guess he would be typical of that guy you say could go bear hunting with a switch, sleeps anywhere he wants to. He can do it all.
He was an outstanding pitcher at the University of Minnesota.
Ball two, no strikes to Darrell Evans. Darrell hit the ball a long way his first time up into center field. Claudel caught it. And the 2-0 pitch from Rhoden. A strike. Chuck Wozlik tells us Darrell batting against Rhoden in the National League hitting for a .462 average. And he acted like it the first time up. He drove it deep into center field, but it's a long way out there. 385 the power alley in right center. 411 in left center. Ball two and strike two. Well, he almost got him with a good slow curveball. 3-2 to Darrell. And the payoff pitch from Rhoden. He walked him. Darrell Evans gets the first walk tonight given up by Rhoden. A two-out walk, and the batter is John Grubb. John sent a ground ball to Willie Randolph his first time. We're in the fourth inning. Yankees 2 and the Tigers nothing. And the pitch to Grubb. That's a strike. Boy, he's got about three different speeds on the curveball. And about the same with the fastball. He can throw hard when he wants to. Here's the slow curve. One ball, one strike. Kansas City beat Boston 10-2. Minnesota has a 6-0 lead in the first inning against Seattle at home. Outside. Ball two, strike one. John Grubb could tie it up with one swing of the bat, and he's looking for his first base hit. And this one gets away, and down to second goes Darrell Evans. Let's see what happens here. Well, it hits in front of the plate for starters, and that's a tough play.
A wild pitch charged
against Rick Rhoden. And we'll see how he elects to pitch to John Grubb with first base open and a right-handed batter coming up. You've got to figure that this cagey veteran right-hander's got a pitch for this occasion. Ball three, strike one. And a base hit. That'll get a run in. John Grubb gets his first hit in the 86 campaign, and the Tigers get on the board. He tried to throw the fastball by him, and John Grubb would have no part of that.
Yeah, big base hit for Johnny Grubb, and that's going to do him a world of good. You see, they wanted to pitch out over the plate, and again, even the good pitchers make a mistake. He got this one in the middle of the plate.
Well, Washington makes a fine play to hold it to a single. And the batter is Darnell Coles, who struck out his first time up. Rhoden has struck out three and walked one. And the walk cost him here in the fourth inning. He got the first two batters, walked Evans. Wow pitched him to second and gave up a base hit. And it's one strike to Darnell. Ball hit towards shortstop. Collison flips it on over to Willie Randolph. Tigers get a run. One run in the inning, strand a man. We go to the bottom of the fourth. Yankees 2 and the Tigers 1. Here come the Yankees in the fourth inning. Gary Ward, Paliarulo, and Skinner will be facing Jack Morris. Gary Ward bounced into a double play his first time up and got Morris out of a jam in the first inning. They had two runs in, runners at first and third, one out, when he bounced it down to Brookins. So he leads off here in the fourth. And a strike at the knees. A one strike pitch from Jack Morris. The Prince William Yankees down on the farm won today.
They did.
Where are they located?
I don't know.
Well, they beat Durham, I'd have to say, in the Carolinas somewhere. There's one hit to Brookins. Never heard of Prince William. The Prince William Yankees beat Durham today down on the farm. It's one away, and it'll bring up Paliarulo. I'm not going to tell those good people in Prince William you didn't know where they were located.
Why would you ask me such a tough question to begin with?
Before you could get the book out there.
I'm looking at it right now.
Here's a ground ball to first. Darrell Evans will pick it off and make the play unassisted. Out number two in the fourth inning, and Joel Skinner will be the batter. Harvey Green will tell you. You can find him as he goes by, the PR man for the Yankees. A pitch to Joel Skinner. Oops. He swung at it. We get the call from Joe Brinkman at first base. Five to two, Pittsburgh leads the Mets. They're in the fourth inning. Pitch outside to Skinner. He's 0 for 1. He bounced to Darnell his first time up. Yankees 2, Tigers 1. We're in the fourth inning. And the pitch coming to Skinner, and he fouls it away. Not a large crowd on this Monday night in New York, but a very noisy crowd as always here at Yankee Stadium. The 1-2 pitch. That'll make it 2-2. Ball two and strike two to Joel Skinner. And the pitch coming up from Jack Morris. He fouls it away. That is Mike Smithson pitching for the Minnesota Ball Club. They got six in the first inning. He's out. Jack got the breaking ball over, and Joel Skinner strikes out. At the end of four, the Yankees 2 and the Tigers 1. Well, the Tigers come to bat in the fifth, trailing by one run. Yankees got two in the first. Tigers picked up a run in the fourth. Chet Lemon will lead it off, and he takes a strike. Chet's 0 for 1. He flied to left field his first time up. Foul tip right off the mask of Joel Skinner.
Chet Lemon has done very well against the Yankees throughout his fine career. A 304 lifetime hitter against the Yankees.
He's behind Rhoden with a strike two count. White Sox got a run. Milwaukee 2, Chicago 1. Milwaukee trying to set a major league record for consecutive wins at the beginning of the season. They have 12. That ties them with Atlanta, who had the record. The American League record is 11 by the Oakland Ball Club. That's Lou Piniella. Well, the scoreboard is not working at the moment. But it's one ball and two strikes. That'll make it 2-2. Ball two, strike two to Lemon, leading off in the fifth inning. Rick Rhoden delivers and a base hit into right. Chet Lemon opens the fifth inning with a base hit. Well, the tying run is aboard with nobody out, and the batter will be Lowry.
Looks like Chet hits a very good pitch here. You can see the ball running away from him on the low outside part of the plate. I tell you, when you hit the ball to right field, you better run towards first base hard because Winfield can throw.
Lowry had a base hit in the third inning. Ooh, he almost picked him off.
I think if I were the manager, I'd change the signs because it looked like Chet was about to run.
Tigers were going to play a little run and hit. Rick Rhoden gets ready, and the pitch to Lowry is hit on the ground, off the glove of the first baseman, and Randolph will throw it out. Oh, some great defensive work. I think Mattingly got a piece of it, slowed it down just enough for Randolph to come in behind him, pick it off, and throw him out. Take a look at it now. Well, we can't tell for sure there, but what a play by Randolph, a diving stop, and on over to Rhoden. Down to second goes Lemon, and the batter will be Brookins. Whether he touched it or not, it took a great play by Willie Randolph, who made a diving stop on a ball that looked like it was headed for right field. One ball, no strikes to Brookins. He'll make it 2-0. Ball two, no strikes. Tommy hit it a mile his first time up, but it was caught about 390 feet away in left center field. And a strike. Ball two and strike one. The 2-1 pitch to Brookins. And they get 2-2. He got the breaking ball by Brookins. And the count goes even. Lemon, the runner at second, carries the tying run for the Tigers. And the 2-2 pitch to Tommy. Ball hit right to the mound. Well, Tommy Brookins is out. Second out of the inning, and it'll leave it up to Whitaker. Lou's been to the plate twice, flied to center field in the first inning, struck out in the third.
And it's a situation here with a base open at first base. They would like to get Lou Whitaker out, but it's not necessary to challenge him with an empty base at first base. And I'm sure that's what Joel Skinner was talking to Rick Rhoden about. They would rather pitch to Sheridan than to Lou Whitaker.
Well, we'll see what happens. Here's the pitch to Lou, and it's a ball. One ball, no strikes. Here's the runner at second, Chet Lemon. And the pitch to Whitaker. Ball two. Ball two, no strikes. That game at Boston today, Saberhagen was the winner. He's 3-0 on the year. Bruce Hurst, fine left-hander, takes the loss. He's 2-1. Outside. This is what you call pitching around a man. Looks like Rhoden wants to take his chances with Pat Sheridan. And he does. He walked him. Whitaker goes to first. Tigers have him at first and second. Two outs, and it'll be up to Pat Sheridan. That's Steve pitching for Toronto tonight. Cleveland leads it 3-1 in the bottom of the third inning. Scott Bales is the pitcher for the Cleveland club. Sheridan has had a hit tonight. He's 1-for-2. And he pops this one foul out of play. De Leon is pitching for Chicago against Nieves. Milwaukee has just scored another run. 3-1. Chicago batting in the second inning. Greg Brock had a two-run homer in the first inning. And Minnesota got six in the first inning off Morgan. He's out of there. A pitch to Sheridan. Outside. Monteleone has relieved Morgan in the first inning. Mike Smithson is pitching for Minnesota. The 1-1 pitch coming up to Pat Sheridan. And a strike. He got the outside corner. One ball, two strikes. We're getting action in the Yankee bullpen. It's Pat Clements. 1-2 to Sheridan. Two on and two outs. Tigers trail by a run. And he fouls it away. Lemon opened this inning with a base hit to right. Lowry was out on an outstanding play by Willie Randolph. Down to second with Lemon. Brookins bounced to the mound for the second out of the inning. Then Whitaker walked. Now it's 1-2 to Sheridan. One ball, two strikes. And a pop fly foul behind the Tiger dugout. Pat Clements, a left-hander, throwing in the Yankee bullpen. They got him from Pittsburgh along with Rhoden. Here's a fly ball to left. They play him just right, and Pasqua puts it away near the line. Tigers threaten, fail to score. We go to the bottom of the fifth. The Yankees 2 and the Tigers 1. Two to one, the Yankees lead as they come to bat in the fifth inning. The Tigers put two runners aboard in the top of this inning, but a fly ball to left, and Pasqua right on the line to pick it off. And the Tigers fail to score. Wayne Tolleson will lead it off. Tolleson, Claudel Washington, and Willie Randolph will be the batters. They are tied at 3 apiece in Chicago as Milwaukee goes for 13 straight. Here's the pitch to Tolleson, hit on the ground to Brookins. Tommy will throw him out. One pitch and one out in the fifth inning. It'll bring up Claudel Washington. Claudel's had a walk tonight and scored a run in the first inning. Yankees got their two in the first inning on a walk to Washington and a two-run homer by Mattingly. Morris delivers and a drive base hit into the corner. This may be extra bases. Claudel on his way to second, and he's going to hold with a double. Jack flopped a big change of pace up there, and Claudel stayed with it. Willie Randolph will bat. Willie's 0 for 2. He's bounced to the mound and bounced to the shortstop. Jack Morris checking his runner. Claudel stole second base in the first inning. A good shot from our camera in center field. You see the strike as Tim Welke went up with the right hand. One strike to Randolph. Runner at second, one out. And a ball hit deep in the hole. They won't get anybody. Oh, Brookins made a whale of a play, but he just couldn't get him. You won't do it any better than this.
I didn't think there was any chance that he would even throw the ball to first base. A very close play at first base. You see the ball hit well into the hole. That shortstop, Tommy, throws off balance. A good throw to first base.
That's as good as you can do it, and Willie Randolph just beats it out. So he's got to get Mattingly with two on and one out. And the pitch is low. Don Mattingly had a home run, a two-run homer in the first inning, then he walked his second time up. One ball, no strike. Right to the mound. That might be a double play. One out. Nope. Jack had to take a double hitch at it. I don't know whether he got it hung in his glove or what. And by the time he did get it down to Brookins, Willie Randolph was right on top of him. Now watch Jack.
George, I think he was waiting for someone to cover. He didn't think anybody was close enough. And then he gives him a bad throw sort of into the runner.
Jack was a bit upset. He wanted out of the inning, and it looked like he was going to be out of the inning. But the Tigers could not turn the double play. So first and third, and he's going to have to get the very tough Mr. Winfield. This is what they call giving an extra out. You hate to do it with a guy like Winfield coming up. And a strike, one strike to Winfield. Dave's been on twice. He was safe on an error in the first inning, walked in the third inning. Washington, the runner at third, Mattingly at first, two outs. And the one strike pitch to Winfield. This will be out of play. Strike two to Big Dave. Two strikes to Winfield. Jack Morris trying to hold him in. The Yankees with a one-run lead in the fifth inning. Have runners at first and third, two out. And the two-strike pitch. Let him make it one and two. They are extremely deep in the outfield for this big guy. And he struck him out. He got it in on the fist, and Winfield strikes out. At the end of five, the Yankees two and the Tigers one. We're going to pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're watching Tigers 87.
This is Kirk Gleason. Coming up in our late news, we'll have reports on Governor Blanchard's call for a crackdown on guns in schools and on an historic return to northern Michigan. These stories and more after the game.
Noakes will lead it off in the sixth inning. Matthew is 0 for 2. Bounce to the shortstop, fly to right. And a strike. He takes a slow curve. The hits are even at four apiece. The Yankees lead it 2-1. And the one strike pitch to Noakes. Strike two, he fouls this one on the screen. Matthew has not had a real good swing against Rhoden yet.
He's kept him off balance pretty much all night by throwing him a lot of slow pitches and then throwing something hard in on his hands, and Matt is just fouling the ball back.
It's strike two as Rhoden gets ready. That'll make it 1-2. Cleveland scored again, 4-1. At the end of four, they lead Toronto. Bales against Steve in that ball game. And the 1-2 pitch. He got him. Tim Welke said it got the outside corner, and Noakes is out on strikes.
Well, you see the pitch. You can see that they do not like to throw Matt Noakes a couple fastballs in a row. They started him off with slow breaking pitches, throw him something hard inside, and then come back with something off speed.
So with one out, Darrell Evans steps in. Darrell has flied deep to center, walked and scored the Tiger run his last time up. And he hits this one on the ground foul. One strike to Evans. We're in the sixth inning. One out, nobody on. Yankees two and the Tigers one. Ooh, he hit it a mile, but he pulled it foul. Darrell hit it in the third deck here in Yankee Stadium. And the race is on by the fans into that portion that's unoccupied to get a souvenir baseball. Now they can't find it. It's there. It's like hunting Easter eggs. Pitch is low to Darrell Evans. Hey, she got it. A young girl got it. The 1-2 pitch and 2-2 to Evans. Ooh, that was close. Ball two and strike two. Full count to Darrell Evans. He was very careful with him last time up. Ball three, strike two. John Grubb will bat next. And a foul ball. Here's the boss man, Sparky, says we need a run to get back in this game. One long drive would do it. Ball three, strike two. And another foul. The big guy getting ready for the payoff pitch. And he walked him. That's the third walk given up by Rhoden tonight. Two of those going to Darrell Evans. And the batter is Grubb, who has batted in the lone Tiger run. John singled in the fourth inning, his first hit in the 1987 campaign, and drove in Darrell Evans. That was his third run batted in of the year. And a strike. He got it on the outside corner to John. They play Grubb well around toward right field. Missed on the outside. If Grubb should hit a ball like Sheridan hit to end the last inning, everybody would be running for a long time. Pasqua is well over into left center. Here's the runner at first, Darrell Evans. And the pitch to John Grubb is outside, ball two. Ball two, strike one. Nobody throwing in the bullpen. They had Pat Clements, a left-hander. Now I think he's going to start throwing again. He was throwing in the fifth inning when the Tigers had two runners aboard. Here's a drive into left center. This is in for a base hit. Darrell will stop at second, and the Tigers put him at first and second, one out.
Well, you can just see Johnny Grubb after getting that first base hit and driving in a run that he has a lot more confidence at the plate. It's a very good pitch, a ball. He's trying to keep the ball down and away, and he did exactly that. John hit the ball line drive in the left field.
Lou Piniella, the Yankee manager, telling somebody to get on the phones. They've got a right-hander and a left-hander throwing in the bullpen. Clements is the left-hander.
Galante is the right-hander.
Well, this is an all-Pittsburgh show tonight. These are the three pitchers they got from the Pittsburgh club, Rhoden, Galante, and Clements. And the batter is Darnell Coles. Darnell is looking for his first hit tonight. Pitch is low. One ball, no strikes. Evans at second, Grubb at first. Tigers are not blessed with their great speed on the bases, but this is a big ballpark and you can't bunch anybody. Ball two, no strike.
Well, the Tigers have seen enough of Rhoden that they should know his style of pitching, and he knows what he's doing on the mound. He is not going to give the Tigers that good pitch to hit inside until he gets two strikes. He wants to stay away from the hitters.
Ball two, no strikes to Darnell Coles. Ball three, 3-0. Chet Lemon would bat next. Ball three, no strikes.
Sparky very seldom lets anyone hit 3-0. Darnell not swinging the bat well, so he will probably get the take sign.
We'll see. And he takes it on the inside corner. He just barely got a strike over. Ball three, strike one. Looked like he was aiming for the center of the plate, and he caught the inside part of the plate. Foul tipped that one right into the mitt of Skinner. We're going to look at that one again as Darnell has a big swing at it.
But you see him leaving the plate. He's stepping towards third base. You see the hips go too soon.
Well, let's see if they're running. Ball three, strike two with one out. They are. Struck him out, and he'll throw him out. Darrell Evans had no chance at all at third base. Once Darnell Cole struck out, Darrell Evans was an easy out, a double play, and they get out of the inning. We go to the bottom of the sixth, New York 2, Detroit 1.
Tigers 87 continues, brought to you in part by your neighborhood Taco Bell restaurants. Hey, Michigan, say hello to Taco Bell. And by Ballpark Franks. They plump when you cook them. And Ballpark Bologna, the only bologna good enough to be called Ballpark.
Well, Sparky Anderson running the base runners to stay out of the double play, figuring that Darnell would at least get a piece of the ball, but it backfires and Evans is an easy out at third base.
So the Tigers mounted a threat against Rhoden, and the double play got him out of it. Pasqua will lead it off. Dan Pasqua, Gary Ward, and Mike Pagliarulo for the Yankees in the sixth inning. Yankees 2 and the Tigers 1. Pasqua had a base hit in the first inning, then he flied to left field with two runners aboard in the third. Morris and Rhoden. Just about what you would expect when you pit one of these fellows against the other. Jack gave up two runs in the first inning on a two-run homer by Mattingly. Rhoden gave up a run in the fourth inning when John Grubb singled in a run from second base. Tigers have out-hit the Yankees 5-4, but they trail 2-1. And the 1-0 pitch to Pasqua. That'll make it ball two. Minnesota 7, Seattle 1. That's at the end of three. Ball three, 3-0 to Pasqua. Jack in danger of walking the leadoff man. Ball three, no strikes. That'll make it 3-1. Pasqua taking all the way. This fellow has home run power. You have to be careful with him. Ball three, strike two. In Lakeland this spring, this fellow hit a mammoth home run against the Tigers. Against the wind. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Fly ball into left center field. John Grubb will handle this one. Well, Pasqua is out. Jack fell behind 3-0 and came back to get him. And the batter will be Gary Ward. Gary's 0 for 2. Both times he has hit the ball to Tom Brookins. A double play ball in the first inning, and then he bounced out in the fourth. And a pitch outside. One ball, no strikes. Ball hit to third off the glove of Darnell, and a base hit for Ward. Darnell got a glove on it and it slid into left field. Hit number 5 for the Yankees. Ball just out of the reach of Darnell, who tried to make a diving stop. And the batter will be Mike Pagliarulo. Mike's 0 for 2. Hit the ball hard his first time up, right straight to Sheridan. There's a long drive into right field, and this one is gone.
And Jack Morris knew this was gone the minute he left the ball go. He made a mistake. Up and into the strike zone. The ball hit the facing of the third deck here at Yankee Stadium.
Take a look at it now. As Al Kaline told you, this ball hit the facing of the third deck, and never much doubt about it. Right here. Just missed going into the third deck. 4-1, the Yankees lead on a couple of two-run homers. And the batter is Joel Skinner. That's his first home run since August 24th, 1986. And a pitch inside to Skinner. Ball two, no strikes. Skinner bounced out his first time up, then he struck out in the fifth inning. He's waiting on the 2-0 pitch. Ball three, 3-0 to Skinner. It has not been an easy inning for Jack. He fell behind Pasqua 3-0. Got him out. Then he gave up a single to Ward and a home run to Pagliarulo. Now it's 3-0 to Joel Skinner. Ball four. Joel Skinner gets a walk, and Sparky has given the signal to Darrell Evans to buy a little time for him. There's nobody throwing in the Tiger bullpen. You can see Sparky upset with somebody. Wayne Collison, the batter. And a base hit into right center. Skinner makes the turn. He's headed for third, and down to second goes Tollefson. Wayne Tollefson on the first pitch rifles it into right center.
Well, this was a bad play on the part of Tommy Brookins. Sheridan throws the ball at third base. Tommy has a chance to cut the ball off here and get the runner at second base, and or at least keep the double play in order.
We'll bring Sparky to the mound. Looks like Thurman throwing, and he has not been throwing long. All of this happened rather quickly. Paliarulo hit the first pitch into the third deck against the facing of the third deck. Skinner walked on four pitches, and then Tollefson hit the first pitch. Well, this has been rather sudden.
The one thing Jack Morris has not gotten over, and you can see Thurman down in the bullpen. Jack, when he gets upset with the umpire, if they make a bad call, he's just not able to forget it. It happened in the first inning, and again, it happened again here.
And Sparky has just been thrown out of the ball game. Sparky paid a visit to the plate umpire on his way in, and Tim Welke tossed him out of the game. I don't think Sparky knew he threw him out of the game. Now he's going to come out and discuss it with him.
And Sparky's going to get his money's worth now. If he's going to get thrown out, he's going to have his say.
Sparky said, "Did you throw me out of the game? I didn't know it."
He's probably saying, "What did I do?"
Sparky gives him that bewildered look. "Wait a minute," he said. "Whoa, whoa." This could go on for a little while. We're going to get a look at now Sparky telling him, and here he is throwing him out. Welke said that's enough. Joe Brinkman is the umpire in chief of this crew, and Joe is trying to restore order. It could be that he's getting Thurman ready to pitch to the left-handed hitting Washington. Sparky is not going to go without getting the final word in. That's it. That's all, Sparky said. That'll be it. So he's going to let Morris pitch to Claudel Washington. They'll have him at second and third. And there's still only one out in the inning.
Of course, Sparky will just stay down in the runway, and Yankee Stadium just out of sight. He will continue to run the game.
Could be they're going to put Washington on. I think that's what will happen, and let Jack pitch to the right-handed hitting Randolph. That's the way they're going to play it. They're going to walk Washington and let Jack pitch to the right-handed batter. Claudel's had a walk tonight and a double. So he's one for two. He flied to center field his second time up. It's been the home run ball that's hurt Jack. Mattingly had a two-run homer in the first inning. Paliarulo's had a two-run homer this inning.
And a home run hurt Jack, but you're not going to win many games when a team only scores one run for you.
Base is loaded for Willie Randolph. Well, he's had a base hit tonight, 1-for-3. He bounced to the mound, bounced to the shortstop, and singled deep shortstop. Tigers have shortened up a bit. They'll go for the double play ball. And a strike to Randolph. 4-1. The Yankees lead it. Bases loaded, one out. We're in the sixth inning. And the one strike pitch to Willie. That'll make it 1-1. Jack got the first batter this inning, and he hasn't been able to get anybody else out. And a pop fly. Infield fly rule in effect as Whitaker picks it off. So Randolph is the second out of the inning. And he's going to have to get Don Mattingly with the bases loaded. Bases loaded for Mattingly. He's had a home run and a walk tonight. And a strike on the outside corner. Jack Morris gets ready, and the pitch to Mattingly is fly ball foul. This will be out of play. Some 15 rows back into the crowd. So a strike two. Well, this crowd is very much into the ball game right now. We set up for the strikeout pitch. As Jack Morris gets ready. And a fly ball in the center. It'll get him out of the inning. Chet Lemon waits for it to come down, and the inning is over. They get two on the two-run homer by Paliarulo. And at the end of six, the Yankees lead it 4-1. Bring you up to date. Cleveland leads 5-1 at the end of five over Toronto. They're playing in the fourth inning in Chicago, and it's tied at 3-3. Minnesota has an 8-3 lead over Seattle at the end of four. They got six in the first inning. Chet Lemon will lead it off for the Tigers in the seventh inning. Chet's had a hit tonight, 1-for-2. The pitch coming up from Rhoden. This will be out of play back on the screen. Yankees got two in the bottom of the sixth. They had the bases loaded, one out, but Morris got Willie Randolph to pop it up and Mattingly to fly into straightaway center field. Look out. One ball, one strike. Pitch is low and it's ball two. Ball two, strike one to Lemon. Tigers had a great chance in the sixth inning. They had two runners on with one out. There's a fly ball into right. Winfield into the corner and he'll catch it. Ball was curving away from him. The wind was blowing it, and Big Dave had to go near the foul line to get it.
And you can see it's not very deep down the right field line, only 3-10.
And there's only about one step, would that be about right, between the foul line and the fence?
Not where, much more than that.
Where he caught the ball. One Winfield step.
Yes.
Dwight Lowry, the batter. And a strike right down the middle to Lowry. Dwight singled in the third inning. And was out on a great play by Randolph, his second time up. And he pops it up. Collison waits on it, and he'll put it away. Two quick outs here in the seventh inning. And the batter will be Tom Brookins.
Well, Rhoden knows he has three runs to work with now. He won't try to be quite as fine with his pitches. If he makes one mistake, he'll only give up one run. So he'll challenge the hitters more right now.
Tommy Brookins takes it outside. Tom flied deep to center his first time up. Then he bounced to the mound. So he's 0 for 2. Ball 2. 2-0 to Brookins. They're in the fifth inning in Chicago, tied at 3. Milwaukee trying to set a new major league mark of 13 straight. Ball 3, no strikes. Whitaker would bat next if Brookins can get on. A 3-0 pitch. He walked him. Well, Tommy is on with a two-out walk. That's the fourth batter that Rhoden has walked tonight. He normally doesn't walk that many.
Comes Pinella.
He's got a left-hander, Clements, throwing in the bullpen. He just might make a change here.
He might. Rhoden didn't pitch all that much in spring training. He got bombed out in the first game. Pitched 6 innings the second game. And of course Lou Piniella knows that the Tigers are loaded with left-handed batters. And he's going to make a change.
He sure is. He's going to make the change. He has given the signal to the bullpen for Pat Clement. Well, with one swing of the bat against the right-hander, Whitaker would have a better chance of bringing the Tigers back to within one. But while there's a break in the action with the score of the Yankees 4, the Tigers 1, we're going to pause for these messages.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the Detroit Baseball Club and is intended solely for the private, non-commercial use of our audience. Any use or reproduction of this game without the written consent of the Detroit Baseball Club is prohibited. The announcers for these telecasts are selected by the Detroit Baseball Club and WDIV and compensated by WDIV.
Well, Pat Clements, the new pitcher for the Yankees, he came to the Yankees along with Rhoden. He originally was with the California Angels. He was traded to Pittsburgh when California received John Candelaria. He has a record this year of 1-0. Even though he is 1-0, he has an earned run average of 12.00. He's been in 3 games, pitched only 3 innings, allowed 3 hits and 4 runs. And he has a very deliberate motion to home plate. He looks like sort of like a hunting dog on point. There's a lot of breaking pitches.
He'll be facing Whitaker with a runner at first base and 2 outs. Yankees have a 3-run lead in the seventh inning. Lou's 0 for 2, flied to center, struck out, and he walked his last time up. And he chops this one foul. Yankees got 2 in the first on a 2-run homer by Mattingly, 2 more in the sixth on a 2-run homer by Paliarulo. Tigers got 1 in the fourth inning on a single by John Grubb. And the one strike pitch to Lou Whitaker. Right back to the mound. Clement picked it off as Whitaker hit it sharply right back at him. We go to the bottom of the seventh, 4-1 Yankees. Here come the Yankees in the seventh inning. We're getting the attendance figures right now. 20,111. 20,111. Dave Winfield will lead it off. Winfield, Pasqua, and Gary Ward will be the Yankee batters. Yankees have 4 runs on 7 hits. Tigers have 1 run on 5 hits. Dave Winfield is 0 for 2. He's had a walk tonight, and he's been on base twice. And the first pitch from Jack Morris. It's a ball. It's the way they want to pitch Winfield. Off speed, breaking balls. They're going to throw him anything hard. I would imagine, Al, they want to throw it in tight, don't they?
Yeah, he doesn't like the ball in. And a lot of times when he takes a pitch inside, he falls down. He doesn't see the ball real well inside.
Ball 2, no strikes. They're underway in California. Oakland and the California club. There's a strike. Stewart is pitching for Oakland. McCaskill for the California Angels. It's the Oakland Athletics this year.
Right.
No longer the A's. Athletics. The 2-1 pitch. Strike 2. He changed up on him good. 2-2 to Winfield. Dodgers are at Candlestick Park. They're about ready to go. Cincinnati will play in San Diego. Ball 2 and strike 2. It's the fastball inside. 3-2 to Winfield. Three, strike 2. Ball hit hard to left field. Base hit for Winfield as he drilled it hard. He's on go when you throw that fastball.
Dave Winfield probably hits the ball as hard as anybody down the third baseline. See Darnell again. Sprawled as far as he could get, but could not come up with the ball.
This is Pasqua. He's had a hit tonight, 1 for 3, and twice he's flied to left field. Dan Pasqua. Fly ball. This may reach the seats. Whitaker chasing it, and it's going to be back in the crowd. Is throwing a lot of let up pitches here late in the ball game. He was a little out of rhythm in the first inning, seemed to get his stride. Then last inning he was having problems. Scooped out of the dirt by Lowry. One ball, one strike. Runner at first is Winfield, and the pitch to Pasqua. We'll make it 1-2. One ball, two strikes.
You know, Ted Williams once said hitting is 50% above the shoulders. And you wonder when these guys are ever going to quit looking for the fastball and start looking for off-speed pitches.
Jack Morris delivers and a foul pass first base. I guess you look for what you can hit best.
Well, but you have to give the pitcher a lot of, you know, some credit out on the mound, particularly the good ones like a Jack Morris. And they know exactly what you can hit. They have scouting reports, and they're not going to give you that pitch to hit unless it comes down to where it's they have to throw you a strike.
Winfield doesn't run that much, but you have to keep an eye on him. He can run. There's a fly ball to right. This will be caught. Sheridan is there. And Pasqua's out. Looks like he hit it down on the trademark. It's one away, and it'll bring up Gary Ward. Tigers have a right-hander and a left-hander in the bullpen. The right-hander's King. The left-hander's Thurman. Lowry at the mound to talk to his pitcher. Gary Ward bounced into a double play his first time up. Then he bounced out to Brooken. Singled and scored a run in the sixth inning. Runner at first, one out. We're in the seventh. There goes the runner. And a ground ball up the middle. Whitaker will throw the runner out at first. He almost made a double play. Lou was going over to cover. Under normal conditions, this would have been a base hit. But when Whitaker went over to cover, he picks it off right here. He was trying to stay on the bag.
And look at Tommy Brookins. He's diving for the ball. He thought the ball was going through, trying to knock it down.
And Whitaker was asking the umpire if he's out at second before he threw to first. He got the call no, and he threw to first in time to get Ward. And the batter is Pagliarulo. Pagliarulo hit a two-run homer his last time up. Winfield's at second, two outs. And the pitch from Morris outside. One ball, one strike.
I'm very surprised he's even pitching to Pags. Man, base open. You got a right-hand hitter hitting only 100 coming up after him.
Foul ball. One and two to Pagliarulo. White Sox just scored a run in the bottom of the fifth. They go in front of Milwaukee 4-3. Nieves is out of the ball game. He had a no-hitter his last time out. Ball hit hard to Evans. There's the throw to Morris. He's out. No runs in the inning. One hit. They strand a man. And at the end of seven, the Yankees lead it 4-1. Here's our upcoming TV schedule. We're going to be right back here at Yankee Stadium tomorrow night at 7:30, and again on Wednesday night at 7:30. Then on Sunday, April 26, we'll be at home at 1 o'clock. Kansas City will be in town. We're going to get a pinch batter for Pat Sheridan. Larry Herndon will come on to bat for Sheridan with the left-hander Clements on the mound.
Had a couple writers come up to me before the game today in the locker room asking me about the home run that Larry Herndon hit at Tiger Stadium.
You'd like to see that ball hit right here.
Yeah.
Nothing could stop it here.
The announcers on in New York said it was the longest home run they had ever seen at Tiger Stadium in center field. And I told him it looked like a golf ball going out over the fence.
Pitch is outside and it's 2-0. Terry Harper has moved to the on-deck circle. He's going to bat for Matt Noakes. Tigers trying to get something going. They are down by three here in the eighth inning.
It looks like Dave Righetti is up throwing in the bullpen.
Yeah, it is Righetti. He started throwing when Clements came to the mound. Ball three. 3-0 to Herndon. Cleveland has a 5-2 lead over Toronto. They're in the bottom of the sixth inning. Indians trying to put it together after a dismal start. He walked him. Larry Herndon walks on four straight pitches to start the eighth inning, and here comes the manager, Lou Piniella. Pinella stopped. He wants to know if Harper is in the game, and he is. He's going to bring a left-hander in anyway. That's all he's got throwing out there.
You got a Dave Righetti in the bullpen with a lead. You're going to bring him in.
Yeah, but he seemed to be worried about whether the right-hander was in the game or not.
Yeah, it doesn't make any difference.
Doesn't matter with Righetti. It's the way Casey Stengel used to do when he had Allie Reynolds out there. He'd act like it was the greatest decision he'd ever have to make in his life, knowing that Reynolds would just blow you away. Well, while there's a break in the action with the score of the Yankees 4 and the Tigers 1, we're going to pause for these messages.
Well, the premier reliever in all of baseball, in my opinion, Dave Righetti, now on the mound for the New York Yankees. Righetti established a major league single season record in saves a year ago with 46, breaking the record held by Dan Quisenberry when he recorded 45 saves in 1983. Righetti off to a outstanding start for the Yankees, a record of 2-0. He has appeared in six games and he has three saves already on the year. Pitched 10 innings, allowed 8 hits and 4 runs. Righetti started out as a starting pitcher, converted to a reliever in 1984. And in the last 3 years, of course, last season being his best season with 46 saves, he had 29 saves in 85 and 31 saves in 84. A power pitcher, nothing fancy about Dave Righetti, even although he does have an outstanding curveball, relies mostly on his fast one.
He was the winning pitcher in Detroit, you remember, on opening day. He came on in the eighth inning, pitched the ninth, and then in the tenth inning, the Yankees got a run, and he got the Tigers 1-2-3 in the bottom of the tenth to get the win. He's coming on now with a runner at first base, nobody out, and the Yankees with a three-run lead in the eighth inning. And he'll be pitching to a pinch batter, Terry Harper, who's batting for Matt Noakes.
And Terry looking for his first hit. Johnny Grubb got his first hit, drove in a run. Maybe this is the night for Terry Harper to break loose.
Eighth inning at Yankee Stadium, 4-1, the Yankees lead it. And a strike to Harper as he blew the fastball by him. There'd be nothing fancy from Righetti. He throws hard, hard curveball, hard slider. There's the slider. And a strike. They got the call from the first base umpire. Strike two to Harper. Let's take a look at it. Terry didn't think he went through with it, but yep,
yeah,
Terry, you did. Gotta say you did, and it's strike two. And the pitch coming up. That'll make it 1-2. That looked like about his third best pitch there. Took something off the fastball, and it was about three-quarter speed. One ball, two strikes. Ground ball, that could be. Oh, he booted it. Should have been a double play ball, and it got away from Tolleson. Ball was hit like a bullet right at Tolleson. He was ready for the double play, and it just skipped away from him. There'll be an error charged against the shortstop.
Looks like a routine double play. You see there, the ball stayed down. Tolleson was expecting the ball to come up. He just didn't keep himself down.
No, the old Phil Rizzuto play. Keep the glove on the ground.
And Alan Trammell, who I mentioned, was available for duty tonight if needed, is going to pinch hit.
Now he's going to bat for Darrell Evans. So the Tigers use their third straight pinch batter here in the eighth inning. Trammell will come on to bat for Darrell Evans with two on and nobody out. A walk to Herndon, in the air by Tolleson. And the pitch. That's a strike. He got a breaking ball over to Trammell. Everybody back on the infield. They're straight away in the outfield for Trammell. Here's a drive into right center. Winfield is there, and he's going to catch it. Trammell hit the ball hard in the gap in right center, and Winfield closed the gap quickly.
Yeah, he got an excellent jump on the ball, and of course the ball will carry curve towards the right-hander off of the bat of a right-handed hitter. You see the ball there. He got an excellent jump. Good outfielder.
Good ball player.
Yes.
Heath is going to bat for Grubb. Mike Heath will come on to bat for John Grubb. The fourth pinch batter here in the eighth inning. Tigers down by three. And the pitch to Heath. It's a ball. Runner at second is Herndon. At first is Harper. One out. One ball, no strikes to Mike Heath. That'll make it 2-0. Ball two, no strikes. Tigers finally get down to a right-handed batter after Heath. Darnell Coles in the on-deck circle. The umbrellas are up, Al.
Yep, starting to come down pretty good.
Ooh, did he check his swing? He did. Ball three. Joe Brinkman at first base gave the call. 3-0 to Mike Heath. We see how Mike gets right on top of the plate. He doesn't give him much of a target, but it did not bother Rigetti. Ball three, strike one. He can be very selective on this pitch. And he popped it up. Mike helped him out. He swung at a pitch, looked like it was out of the strike zone. We're going to pause 10 seconds for station identification. You're watching Tigers 87.
This is Kirk Gleason. Coming up in our late news, we'll have reports on Governor Blanchard's call for a crackdown on guns in schools and on an historic return to Northern Michigan. These stories and more after the game.
It's going to be up to Darnell Coles. Two on and two outs in the eighth inning. Darnell is 0 for 3, and he struck out twice against Rick Rhoden. And takes a strike on the outside corner. Tigers put the first two on this inning, then Trammell lined to right field. Heath flied to left. Breaking ball is low. One ball, one strike. You see the base runners, Herndon at second and Harper at first. Darnell is looking for his first home run of the year. He's batted in five runs. A 1-1 pitch from Rigetti. It's low, ball two. Ball two, strike one.
Darnell hit a home run the last day of the season a year ago to have 20, and it's only the second time in history all the regular infielders had 20 or more home runs on a team.
This one foul down the right field line. And the count goes even at 2-2. Rigetti is the third Yankee pitcher. Rhoden, Clements, now Rigetti. Rhoden is the pitcher of record. And the 2-2 pitch to Darnell. That'll make it 3-2. He threw him a good curveball. Ball three, strike two. They will be off and running on this pitch. Here's the payoff. He fouls it away. Oh, you could almost bet it would just be power against power as Rigetti would go to his best pitch. Pittsburgh has a 9-6 lead over the Mets there in the eighth inning. Ball three, strike two, and the runners going on the 3-2 pitch. Another foul ball. Darnell might have helped him a bit, but you don't have much time with Rigetti throwing. You got to make up your mind quickly whether to pull that trigger or not. Dave Rigetti gets set. And a fly ball to right. Winfield in the corner, and he caught it. Oh, what a play by Winfield. Looked like extra bases, and Dave Winfield ran it down in the corner. What a play.
Well, The Yankees have come up with some great plays, and here's another one. Two runs would have scored on this one.
We go to the bottom of the eighth, 4-1, Yankees.
Well, a bunch of changes. Darnell moves to first base. Alan Trammell in the game at shortstop. Tommy Brookins moves to third base from short. Larry Herndon stays in the game. Heath is in right field. Mikado is now behind the plate.
And Joel Skinner will lead it off in the eighth inning for the Yankees. 4-1, the Yankees lead it. Here's a strike. A tremendous play by Winfield saved a couple of runs. To end the eighth inning for the Tigers. Pitches low to Skinner. One ball, one strike. Skinner's 0-for-2. He's had a walk tonight. This ball hit on the end of the bat. Coles will flip it over to Morris. Oops. Jack lost the bag for a moment. So Skinner is out. First baseman to the pitcher covering the bag. The batter will be Tolleson. Wayne Tolleson had a base hit his last time up. Morris gets ready, and the pitch to Tolleson is low. Cleveland 6, Toronto 2 there in the eighth inning. 4-3, White Sox lead Milwaukee in the seventh inning. Ball two. Ball two, no strikes to Wayne Tolleson. And Chuck Wozlik tells me Milwaukee scored in the seventh, and they've tied it 4-4. The 2-0 pitch to Tolleson. It's a ball, ball three. Well, after yesterday in Milwaukee, the Brewers believe anything can happen. They got a three-run homer from Rob Deere. to tie the ball game at 4-4. And then a two-run homer from Dale Swaim to win it 6-4. The pitch to Tolleson. It's a ball. He walked him. Wayne Tolleson gets a one-out walk in the eighth inning, and the batter will be Claudel Washington. Claudel has had a double tonight and two walks. He replaced Henderson right at the start of the game. Henderson with a slight muscle pull, and he was pulled from the starting lineup. There's a long drive if it stays fair, and it does. A home run for Washington.
Claudel Washington, a 314 career hitter against Detroit Tigers. It's his first home run of the year.
This is what you call wrapping it around the flagpole. It just stays fair around the flagpole. Well, more than that. Down the line, anyway. And it's a 6-1 Yankee lead. All Yankee runs coming tonight on home runs. Three two-run homers. And they lead it 6-1. Willie Randolph, the batter, he's had a single tonight in four trips. And Willie fouls it away. Yankees have six runs on nine hits. The Tigers one run on five hits. There was a walk and a home run in the first inning that sent the Yankees off to a 2-0 lead. A single and a home run in the sixth inning. Single by Ward, a home run by Paliarulo. And a walk and a home run here in the eighth. And it's 6-1. Milwaukee has scored again. Molitor singled in a run, and they lead Chicago 5-4. Trying to make it 13 in a row. And the pitch to Willie Randolph. Check swing foul. It's a funny game, strange game. Everybody picked Cleveland to be the dark horse. They got off to a horrible start, 1-9. Everybody picked Milwaukee to finish last, and they're going for their 13th straight win tonight. One ball, two strikes. This will probably get in the seats. Heath chasing it, but it's going to be out of play.
Milwaukee is going with a lot of young players, and you never know what to expect from young players. Even though they might be good minor league players, you never know how they're going to perform in the major leagues. And of course, when they get off to a great start like this, you gain a lot of confidence.
One ball, two strikes. The pitch to Randolph. It's low. That'll make it 2-2. Jack Mars trying to get him out here in the eighth inning. 6-1, the Yankees lead it. And the 2-2 pitch. Ball hits slowly to third. Tommy's going to have to hurry. Safe. Tough play for Brookins. He got the ball there in time, and it just pops out of the mitt of Darnell as he tries to scoop it up.
Let's see if Darnell who is the first time he's ever played first base in the major leagues.
They score that an error on the first baseman. Error on Darnell. And the batter is Don Mattingly.
It looked like Darnell stretched with the wrong leg. He had the wrong leg on the bag. But that can be expected of someone who has never played over there.
Mattingly had a two-run homer. He's walked. Bounced out and flied to center with the bases loaded his last time up. We'll make it 2-0. Ball two, no strikes. Don Mattingly. Well, he's put a couple of great years back to back. It's low ball three. 3-0. And Billy Muffet's coming out.
They might want to save Jack. He's throwing a lot of pitches here. And they're going to go with Thurman. He's been throwing the whole time. And
here's the left-hander Thurman, and the call has gone to the bullpen from Billy Muffet. They want Thurman to come on with a ball three, no strike count to Don Mattingly.
Well, Jack actually just made three bad pitches. And they were all hit very well. Pitches inside to the left-handed batters. Mark Thurman comes on. Mark, who was with the Detroit Tigers in the middle of last season in a trade with San Diego, Dave LaPointe going to San Diego, and he did it just a whale of a job for the Detroit Tigers last year. He had a record of 4 wins and 1 loss. Thurman so far this season has pitched in 3 games. He has not allowed a run. He has pitched just 2 innings, allowed no hits and no runs. Basically a fastball, slider, and a curveball pitcher. Excellent control. Tries to keep the ball away from the left-handed batters and sink the ball away from the right-handers.
Mark Thurman will come on in relief of Jack Marsh. He'll have a runner at first base, one out, and a ball three, no strike count to Mattingly. Earlier this inning, Washington, Claudel Washington, hit a two-run homer, and the Yankees have increased their margin to 6-1 over the Tigers. Don't forget, we're going to be back here tomorrow night at 7:30 for the second game of this series. Then again on Wednesday night at 7:30 from Yankee Stadium. And on Sunday, we'll be home. Sunday, April 26th, Kansas City will be in town, and that'll be a 1 o'clock game. Mark Thurman completes his warm-up tosses, and he'll be facing Mattingly with no margin of error. Ball three, no strikes. And it wouldn't surprise me at all if he didn't jump on the 3-0 pitch. He figures Thurman's going to have to throw it or try to throw it right down the middle. Nope. He takes it outside, and it's ball four. That'll put him at first and second, one out for Dave Winfield. Dave Winfield. This fellow's had a hit. He's been on base 3 times tonight. scores. Second is Randolph, and at first is Mattingly. And the pitch to Winfield. It's a strike. He got the fastball over. They can double this big guy up, even though he runs well. He hits the ball so hard. If he hits it right at the shortstop, second baseman, or the third baseman, they can double him up. That'll make it one and one.
Winfield has one home run this season. That home run, a lot of the writers here said, was one of the longest home runs they've ever seen hit here, way back in the third deck down the left field line.
Not many hit in the third deck in left field here. The 1-1 pitch. Well, that one was headed for the third deck, but he pulled it foul. Dave Winfield jumped all over an inside fastball, hit it in the third deck, but pulled it foul. One ball, two strikes. Mark Thurman delivers, outside, ball two. Ball two and strike two. Tommy Brookins very deep at third. Trammell and Whitaker set up for the double play ball. And Winfield waits on the 2-2 pitch. And a base hit into center. We'll get a run in, and on to third goes Mattingly. Winfield hit the ball hard into center field, and it's a 7-1 ball game. And the batter is Don Pasqua. Pasqua's had one hit tonight. First and third, one out. Morris got the first batter this inning, and that's been the only batter that the Tigers have been able to retire. After that, a walk to Tolleson, a home run by Washington. Randolph safe on an error. Mattingly walked, and then Winfield got a base hit. That's one ball to Pasqua. Look out. Ball two. This was rather close.
Yeah, this was one of those up under the chin type things. He had just thrown him an excellent breaking pitch. Sort of walked into it, but quite a bit out of the strike zone.
Ball two, no strikes. And a pop fly in the shallow left that'll be caught by Herndon, and there'll be no advance. Mattingly did not tag up. He had no chance to score. That's the second out of the inning. And it'll bring up Gary Ward. Gary Ward had a base hit back in the sixth inning and came in to score on the home run by Paliarulo. 7-1, the Yankees lead it in the bottom of the eighth inning. And the pitch to Ward. It's a ball. Mattingly, the runner at third, Winfield at first, two outs. Curve inside, ball two. Scoreboard gives it one and one. We'll have to wait and see now what Tim Welke says. Gary Ward, the designated hitter for the Yankees. And a ball high. Scoreboard changed it now. It's ball three, no strikes. 3-0 to Gary Ward. And a base hit into right. Ward hit the 3-0 pitch. And in to score comes Mattingly. That makes it 8-1. Gary Ward swinging on the 3-0 pitch, and he drills it into right field.
Well, this is not the way they teach you to hit a 3-0 pitch, but he got the job done. At least he hit the ball hard. Line drive in the right field.
And the batter is Paliarulo. Mike's had a two-run homer tonight. And he was trying to get another one. One strike to Paliarulo. They're in the eighth inning in Chicago. Milwaukee 5 and the White Sox 4. And a strike on the outside corner. Strike 2. Yankees have scored 4 times this inning, and they lead it 8-1. I think the umpire was waiting for the public address announcer to quit giving Morris his record. You could hear it all over the park. And he thought it might have been bothering the batter.
I tell you, he really blasts it out, doesn't he?
He comes on strong.
Yes, he does.
All 8 runs have been charged against Jack Morris, he says. 6 earned runs. The 1-2 pitch to Paliarulo. That'll make it 2-2. Paliarulo getting off to a slow start. He's batting at 217, 1 home run, and he got that tonight. Ball gets away from Mercado, but no advance. Ball 3, strike 2. Winfield, the runner at second, Ward at first, and they'll be running on the 3-2 pitch. Ball 3, strike 2 to Paliarulo. He had 2 quick strikes on him. And he struck him out. They get 4 in the inning. And at the end of 8, the Yankees lead it 8-1. Here come the Tigers in the ninth inning, sending up Chet Lemon. Dwight Lauer is the scheduled second batter. Mercado's in the ballgame now. He'll bat second, and then Tom Brookins. Eight to one, the Yankees lead it in the top of the ninth inning. And they've got their big reliever, Dave Righetti, on the mound. Rick Rhoden started for the Yankees. Pat Clements relieved him, and now Righetti. Righetti came on in the eighth inning after Clements walked the first batter. Chet Lemon has had a single tonight. He's 1-for-3. And a strike from Righetti. Tigers had some chances in the middle of the ball game, but they couldn't get the key base hit. Look out. One ball, one strike. It's the final score. Pittsburgh beat the Mets 9-6. Phillies beat Montreal in their home opener today. And their first game under their new dome stadium. There's a strike. One and two to Lemon. And a tap toward the mound. Easy play for Rigetti. Well, Lemon is out to start the ninth inning. And the batter will be Orlando Mercado. Mercado batting for the first time tonight. One out in the ninth. Tigers down by seven. First of three here in New York. The Tigers come home to play Kansas City over the weekend. Dave Rigetti ready. And a strike right down the middle to Mercado. This is going to be foul and out of play. Ball carried well back into the crowd. One ball, two strikes. And the 1-2 pitch. Foul tip. Yankees using the home run ball tonight. They got three of them, and they were all two-run homers. Mattingly, Paliarulo, and Claudel Washington accounting for six of their eight runs. Here's the pitch. Well, Mercado is on his way to first base. Scoreboard was giving it 2-2, and he's at first base. Brookins will be the batter with a runner at first, one out. The scoreboard has not worked except at intervals tonight. It'll give it 1-2 and then nothing, nothing. So you sort of need an indicator in your hand. One strike to Tommy. Tommy has not had a hit. He's had a walk tonight. Strike two. He threw the curveball over. Two strikes to Tom Brookins. They play well behind Mercado. And a base hit into right. That's going to be extra bases as it gets by Winfield. They're going to hold Mercado at third. And a double for Brookins. Well, the Tigers put them at second and third.
Well, this is real good hitting on the part of Tommy Brookins with two strikes. His main concern is put the ball in play. Rigetti throws a, looked like a hard slider, a hard curveball, and he just sliced the ball down a right field line. You put the ball in play, you got a chance to get on base.
Now, Mickey Mantle said in the paper today he struck out 1,700 and some odd time. He said that's 3 years.
And he walked.
And he walked so many times. That's 4 years. He said 7 years of my career I didn't put the ball in play.
Never went to the plate.
Never went to the plate. One strike to Whitaker. Tigers have him at second and third, one out. We'll make it 1-1. Minnesota 11, Seattle 4 in the eighth inning. They got six in the first inning. Here's a pop fly down the line and left. Not deep enough to get the run in. It's going to be, no, he dropped it. Tolleson got there and then he dropped it. I think he was shying away from the fence and he really wasn't that close to the fence.
I thought Pascal had an easy play of it. He seemed to stop too soon. You see there, he's slowing down. Looked like he might have had an easy play of it. The ball just went into foul territory. Oh, that's a tough play. That's a tough error.
No, I think he should have caught the ball.
You think he did?
I think he should have caught it in his hip pocket. Really? I kid you not.
I know you wouldn't.
I think he should have caught it barehanded. And that's about the way he played it. A pitch to Whitaker. It's inside. Ball two and strike two. But to begin with, you were right. Pasqua should have caught the ball. It was an easy play for Pasqua. And he just let Tolleson take charge. A good outfielder just runs the infielders off those plays. Take charge. Pasqua says, this is my second year, and Tolleson, you've been around 4 or 5 years, so seniority reigns. And a base hit in the left. Whitaker gets a base hit. Brookins will stop at third. Eight to two as Whitaker lines it into left. Tigers have him at first and third. Still only one out. And the batter is Herndon. Larry got into the game as a pinch batter in the eighth inning and drew a walk.
Well, Lou Piniella didn't want this. He didn't want his ace reliever to have this hard of a struggle and throw this many pitches. He may not be able to pitch tomorrow.
He might not pitch anymore in this series. He has thrown a lot of pitches. And a strike to Herndon. He hasn't had a lot of help. When he first came in, he had a double play ball off the bat of Harper right at Tolleson. He bobbled it. That extended the inning. And this might be the double play he's looking for. It is. Willie Randolph takes charge, picks it up, and turns the double play. Tigers get a run. Strand one. Final score, the Yankees 8, the Tigers 2, and we'll be right back. Well, the Yankees got 3 home run balls tonight and went on to beat the Tigers 8-2 in the first of this 3-game series. For Al Kaline and Bernie Smolovitz, this is George Kell, hoping you'll be with us tomorrow night at 7:30 when the Tigers face the Yankees. Once again, the final score tonight, New York 8 and the Tigers 2.
Tigers 87. Today's game was brought to you by Miller Lite. For great taste, there's only one light beer. By McDonald's, it's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's. And by Highland Superstores, they have the biggest selection of TVs, stereos, and appliances in every store. Nobody, but nobody, sells for less.